the longest today. I'm not really looking forward to that. I get hypothermia, because I don't know how to pray. Guys, before we start, we are not going to, I'm not going to spend long talking at all, probably 5 minutes max, and then we're going to get up and we're going to head down, and we're all going to be like a... I'm not saying what we're like, but we're all going to be traveling down together to the beach. On the way up, as we're driving, Lily posed a question to me. She said, why is everybody going to the beach to be baptized? And I said, well, the beach is a good way to be baptized. Jesus, Jesus' followers, Jesus' disciples were baptized people along the Sea of Galilee. They were baptized in that area. Of course, the climate was different there. But they would have used the outdoors to baptize. It wasn't like they had heat back then. And she said, well, I was outside on holiday, and I went underwater in the pool. Does that mean I'm baptized? So I had to kind of break it down a little bit for her and explain, no, it's not, you know, otherwise we're all baptized, we'll have a bath. Baptism, and I've been sharing for the past couple of weeks a little bit along the message, is kind of like wiping off the remnants of the world and standing up and saying, I am a follower of the Word, I'm a follower of Christ. When last week we were talking about how when Jesus sent his disciples out and told them to take nothing, not a knapsack, not money, not food, he said that, well, if you go somewhere and they don't accept you, he said, wipe off your feet, wipe the dust off your feet. And we spent a little bit last week talking about getting rid of that dust. That dust represents the world, and getting rid of the worldly way of thinking. Thinking like how everybody else thinks isn't exactly the way we are. We're seen as a peculiar people. Sorry to point that out. Some of us more peculiar than others. Yeah, I'm not pointing Kelly out, it's just kind of there. But some of us are. And what I want to say today is, see, when we stand up, these people, there's 8 people being baptized today. And when they stand up and they declare their faith is in Jesus, but they're also declaring to the world that they are no longer followers of that way, that instead they are accepting the way of Jesus, the way that went contrary to the norm, the way that said that I'm not following how the Pharisees are following, I'm not following how man is following, but I'm going a different course. And that's what they're doing. Now, we shared in Bible study this week, I was talking, and she's not here, Crystal's not here. Okay, Crystal probably claimed that this was hers, Chris, and that she came up with this, but we'll all just accept it that I said this. Crystal pointed out that about in Genesis, how in Genesis, the Adam and Eve were naked and ashamed, and they sought to clothe themselves with things that they found in the world. Now, you're blessed today because nobody's going into the water naked, but there is something about being naked before God, about letting it all out before God, about not trying to hide things away from God. And we were talking, those who were here last week, we were talking about Isaiah 6, how the angels turn to face God. But quite often, we shared this on Tuesday, that we don't turn all the way to face God, we turn partially, and we try and keep parts of our life hidden from God. Whether it's a case of what we do on a Friday night, or who we're out with, or what we're doing behind closed doors, or even our money and keep our money back, or maybe we trust God over our relationship, but we don't trust God over our healing. We don't trust God over our restoration, but we trust God on certain areas. And that's all to do with how much we expose ourselves. So these people who are standing up today, I'm asking to expose themselves before God. Right? In a metaphorical sense, right? I don't want them stripping, but I want them exposing themselves to the point that they go before God and say, God, whatever part of my life you see that you're needed in, come in and be working in that part of my life. Working in me. I hold nothing back. See, baptism isn't just a ritual. It's a case in which we stand up and we say, God, I am for you. I can't stand up and say, God, I am for you, but part of me, I'm holding back. You can't stand up and say, God, I'm going to race for you, but at the same time, I'm going to go out, I'm going to do this, or I'm going to keep myself occupied, one foot in the world, one foot straddling the world. You cannot be a pew sitter, and you cannot be straddling the fence. Revelation 3 tells us that he will spew out of the mouth those who are lukewarm. He'd rather have you hot or cold, but he would spew out of the mouth those who are lukewarm, those who are sitting going, yeah, God, I trust you, but I'm going to try things on my own. And those who are standing up today, I am blessed to be able to baptize you today. I promise you, I will not drag you. I know I've been asked that today. I will not drag you. I've also been asked, how long were you under the water for? It's a weak game. I'm going to see who can hold their breath the longest. But guys, it is a blessing to stand up before to say, I'm naked before you, God. I'm not trying to hide myself behind anything. I say, I'm completely exposed before you. And I count myself a follower. A follower of you. Amen?
Father God, I thank you for the pledge made today. I thank you for each one. Father, I thank you that that water is supernaturally warm. I thank you that we declare it warm by faith. And Father, I thank you that each one here is now going to be, they're accepting that they are fully, 100% the new creation in Christ. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Do you declare and do you accept that Christ Jesus is your Lord and Savior?
Yes.
Do you accept that the Holy Spirit is your guide? Do you reject the world and accept the word?
Yes.
Well then, in the name of the Father,
the Son, and the Holy Spirit, I baptize you in the name of Christ, in the name of the Holy Spirit, and in the name of the Father, in Jesus' name.
Amen. Here we go, do you accept Christ Jesus as your Lord and Savior?
Yeah.
Do you accept that the world, the word over the world?
Yeah.
Do you reject the ways of the world and accept God the Father, the Holy Spirit, and the Son as your guide?
Yeah.
Well, in Jesus' name, I'm going to baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Do you accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior? Do you reject the ways of the world and accept the word?
Definitely.
Do you say no to sin and accept grace? Well, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, I baptize you.
Well done. Well done.
Do you accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior?
I do.
Do you reject the ways of the world and accept the word?
I do.
Do you reject sin and accept grace?
I do.
Well, in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, I baptize you.
Hey, well done. Well done.
Thank you.
Do you accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior?
Yes.
Do you reject the ways of the world and accept the word?
Yes.
Do you say no to sin and yes to grace?
Yes.
Well, in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, I baptize you.
Thank you, guys.
Do you accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior?
Yes.
Do you reject the ways of the world and accept the ways of the Word?
Yes.
Do you say no to sin and yes to grace?
Yes.
In the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit, I baptize you.
Hey, well done.
Are you okay? Do you accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior?
Totally.
Do you reject the ways of the world and embrace the ways of the Word?
In every way.
Do you say no to sin and yes to grace?
Absolutely, in every way.
In the name of the Father,